Hello, and welcome to day 15, the final day of week 3. Today we'll be doing the dialogue for Sammy, which we only have... It's quite a short one today, I'll be honest, because it's... I didn't really do much. It was very much about getting kind of key poses right. Yeah, key poses right, and then... Yeah. I still tried to animate all the frames. I think I kept the hair very static and then tried to just animate the eyes and the mouth. This is the problem I kind of have personally with the limited animation, or with the anime style, is it is very limited in its, well, not approach, but the style itself lends itself to a very limited style. So it looks more static than it really is. And I'm kind of used to more cartoonish, what I struggle with this week quite a bit, but, you know. You can only struggle with something for so long until you've learned it. I'd like to do this character again. Well, maybe not this character, but the sort of anime style again. I thought it was really fun. And I do like the source material, so ultimately there was, you know, it's a lot going for it. Yeah, so this is the end of week 3. I've got 5 more weeks to go. So that'll be fun. And surprised at how... I guess quick. Is quick the right word? Maybe. Surprised how much has really kind of moved along with this. It's been fun. Stretching. A little cold today. I'm starting to get that winter chill in here. So what can I say? Oh, actually, I know what I can say. I used, for this one, I tried to use a AI-generating voice. It was a text-to-voice AI usage thing, and it used... From what I remember, it used a character from Yu-Gi-Oh! Called My Valentine. So that was just pretty interesting. I was kind of surprised at the results. The first character I used, I think, was, I don't remember who they were, but they just sounded really shit. So then I used this, I went through a couple of characters and eventually I actually got the audio. It's okay, I think there's better ones out there. I don't remember the website I used, but it was really bizarre to see that. The fact that I could actually record dialogue that doesn't exist of a woman, because I can't do a woman's voice. Oh, right, yeah, so I'm just tracing, so yeah, I traced the head. I think I did that because, I don't know, I was just upset with myself because I couldn't get it right. This is what I decided to do. I don't recommend this because it doesn't really teach you, does it? Although now that I think about it, if I traced over just the basic proportions and volumes, but yeah, look how much better that is. So the artist who created Sammy is a guy called Ryo Hirata, who started at Intelligent Systems, the people who made this game. In 2001, I think it was. No, it wasn't 2001. But maybe it was. But he was 21 at the time, so maybe that's what I'm getting at. And I've been very inspired by that guy. So I'm currently in the editing mode of all these videos. So I've been editing about 3 to 4 videos a day. the rendering is what's killing it all. It just takes hours. But hopefully this one should be pretty short, because it's it is a pretty short file. Yeah, so I'm sort of going for that replacement technique again, where I'm keeping... that's why this is short. So what I've done is I've copy and pasted the head and then just added it to every frame. Or I've made a new layer and then redrawn the face for every single frame. No, not redrawn, but just copy and pasted it. I think I only did it as a time-saving measure because I believe I had something to do this day. Well, I've got something to do every day, so that's not really that great of an excuse. Yeah. So I woke up this morning and I was like, okay, what am I doing today? I'm editing videos and what else? And, you know, some chores around the house and some work I gotta do, but I was actually thinking that with these 40 days that I've done at this point, I'd love to plan out my next sort of animation. So that's probably what I'm gonna do now. I don't know. I've got a few ideas, but I don't know which one to run on. So. To be honest, maybe it'll be done in 40 days, I'm not sure, because when this drops, I'll be on holiday for the first week or so, then I've got things to do after the holiday. And then... yeah, then I could only put them out much. But it's Christmas time, so... yeah. I love Christmas, but I'm going to be honest, getting presents for people is a pain. It's hard because it doesn't feel like people actually care about presents anymore. It feels like when you get a present for like a 5-year-old or like a 10-year-old, well, no, maybe younger than that, 5 to 9-year-old and younger, they're like, oh my god, this is the greatest gift ever. Whilst if you get it to an adult, they just go, oh, wait. Very rarely do you get a gift that they actually care about. Which sucks because it makes you go like, oh, I don't want to get them a gift. I feel like that. I don't feel that respected. Well, not respected, but I don't feel that... I think the feeling is just generally that you've put a lot of thought into it and they don't really care. You could have got them something just as shit and probably had the same sort of reaction. That's the feeling I get sometimes. So I really love animating. It's my favourite thing to do. The only problem is, it's, I don't know, when you're with somebody or other people around you aren't really animators, they get very bored by it and they're just... like, for example, my, anytime I'm animating and I have family or my fiancé around, it's like, I feel bad because I'm having to just, for like hours on end, just stare at the same drawing over and over again, focusing and trying to get motion down, and things don't work, but I've got to kind of speed up because I feel like I'm kind of letting them down. That kind of sucks. But yeah, I'd like to plan out my next animation. I think I'd like to incorporate, because one of the things that kind of makes a nice finished animation is background and foreground elements, and I've recently tried a style in a drawing I did a while ago that I really did love for foreground and background elements. Not necessarily ground, I couldn't quite get that down, but just overall I thought it was really lovely. Granted, I could just use AI stuff, maybe make my own stuff, but I don't know. If everybody just uses AI, then what's the point of us even existing? It's like if robots could do all the stuff we do. It's like, well, surely they, at some point, they just go, what would be the point of the people? Just saying. Torn between a few animations at the moment. I try not to cloud my ideas with too many thoughts. Because if I go like, oh yeah, I should do this, 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 and this, I end up thinking about C before I even start today. So we're doing the colouring now. To be honest, I don't really know why I didn't just colour in the... colour in the line work with the bucket. It'll be a lot easier for me. There it is. I think I'm a third of the way done through this sort of time-lapse. I've tried to keep it consistent, so I think this is one is also on 4x speed, even though it was a much shorter animation. I think one of the problems with this animation is because I made it so static, like, I think it would have been nice to have some sort of fluttering in the hair or... just a bit more movement. It's sort of too static, you know what I mean? It's an dialogue animation I do later on that has got too much movement, and this one has too much, not enough movement. So it's a nice, I'm trying to get a nice fine balance between the two. Considering that I'm doing this shading, actually, I can kind of see why I didn't. There's a program called EbSynth that you basically take an animation like this and then color in a few frames in a specific style, and the AI will automatically color for you the rest of the frames, but it doesn't quite work. If it did, it would make this, I would absolutely love it, because I could just apply simple color, like flat colors to things, then shade up a few frames, then it would do it for me. That'd be fantastic. I don't quite know what's going on here. Oh, I know what's going on. So I'm doing the eyes and then that, yeah. Yes, that's what I was trying to do. I have no idea what happened there. What else have we got to say today? I think also in volumes here, I've kind of made the chin a bit too receded, or the neck a bit too kind of receded. I think the audio is let to roll out, or something like that. Let's move out, maybe. So like I was saying the other week with dialogue and trying to get the syllables, let's assume it's move out. I think it might be roll out. Either one works. Because I'm focusing the out. So instead of going with the word out, you go a oot, which would be, to be honest, would be oot. But if you're trying to make that O, U, and then T face, it would sort of move around too much, so it's better to focus on the syllables and kind of like hang on the frame for a bit. That makes sense. Which I probably should have done. And so, for example, without, you would go with out. So the ow and the t. You know, because if somebody stubs their toe and they say ow, they make one face. They don't go out with. You know, they don't make two different faces. They just make a kind of stub my toe face. So the same with that is that you want to follow those syllables primarily over just individual letters, or else you'll end up over animating stuff, which looks very unnatural. I believe we're coming up to time here, so it was quite a short and sweet one today. I really enjoyed it. I hope you did too. And I'll see you tomorrow for the new character. Here's the animation at the end. I hope you like it. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.
Let's move out! Let's move out!